Yeah, that's a weird entrance, isn't it? But yeah, what's good, YouTube? Ghost Majino back again with another episode reaction of Steins Gate. Y'all just saw me shake my shaker, my protein shake, because, you know, I was like, hey, I'm a shake my bottle, but the video already started and I wasn't going to stop. So y'all got a little cameo doing it as we speak. But yeah, Steins Gate heating up, favorite series to watch right now. The last episode when we left off, we learned so much. John Titor basically kind of spoke to Okarin, and then he basically told him two things. How, you know, if the world were to continue, if he doesn't do anything to stop it, there's going to be a dystopia. Like, the world's going to end. It won't end up well for human beings. And Titor also told him that the only way to prevent this was to create a 1% divergence, which from my understanding means altering the time, the timeline, so that one change results in a completely different parallel universe, which erases the memory of the initial timeline and brings in a new one. So as long as Okarin can somehow create a divergence of just 1%, it should be fine. So we learned a lot of content last week's episode. Hopefully there's more of that this week's. And yeah, without further ado, Steins Gate episode 8. Let's hop into it. I ask you to be our savior. Yeah, this guy John Titor is basically just setting Okarin up to be a hero. That's a lot of pressure. Okarin's like, me? A savior? He ain't talking about me. Yeah, he's like, there's no way. I'm a mad scientist. Isn't Makise still behind him? She's probably like, what the fuck? Yeah. They're all there, right? Yes, sir. Reading Steiner. That's sick. That's sick. Reading Steiner sounds like Steins Gate, but man, we still don't know what Steins Gate means. That's crazy. Reading Steiner. She's like, I don't buy it. Did she hear their convo? Because she literally just asked if she could send one as well. That girl's not far. I knew it. I'm like, if she's texting, she gotta be nearby. She lurking. Her name is Kiryu. Okay, got it. I didn't know her name this whole time. Yo, I love how these two have beef for no reason, man. Oh no. Oh no. The Fed. Oh yeah, she is. Oh, the beef. And it's one-sided too. Like, Makise has no clue what's going on. This whole group is just creepy. Aside from Okarin and Daru, the whole group is just creepy. Here we go. Hopefully this works. Yeah, where did Kiryu go? Oh no, did she just die? Oh no. They diverge way too much. Damn. Oh, so she's alive. Okay. Titor was right. You are the savior, bro. It's on you, it's on your shoulders. Oh no, Daru, don't. Okarin's face is my face. Okarin. Yo, initially, I'm gonna try to rewind my initial reaction. I literally went like, same thing Okarin did, bro. I love it. That's hilarious. This whole comedic thing is hilarious, man. She's like, wait a minute. Yeah, she blushing. That does make sense. That does make sense, though. All jokes aside. Hey, Ruka is very, very woke, man. 2021, that's the new wave. Yep. He can choose to be a shorty if he wants to be. She can't believe it. She can't believe it. She's like, hold on, let me catch my breath. Can they make it work through D-mail though? Can they change sex? That's cat. Yeah, that's a whole lot of cap. That's key. Because if they weren't even existing, they couldn't do it. Yeah. They wouldn't get the text message. Yeah. Daru is loving it. Why don't you send an actual email though? Because emails were around way pager. That's pretty clutch. Pagers. I don't really know how they work, to be honest. I guess they would be like walkie talkies, like eat vegetables for a healthy baby. How did he change the message? I'm curious how he changed the message. They're not gonna tell him what he wrote. That thing did not say eat vegetables for a healthy baby. It says some next shit. Yo, they're all gone. Oh no. Okay, they're back there. Okay. And Ruka is still there. I guess Ruka is sitting kind of like a girl, but I don't know if it worked. Oh! She covered them. Ruka covered them. I think it worked. Just because of the way Ruka's reacting and she covered up. I think they did succeed in changing him into a girl. Okarin thinks it failed though. Yo guys, this episode was good. It was really enjoyable. Not a lot of like, you know, deep dives into content like last week. So it was a lot more, you know, relaxing to watch and just kind of, you know, watch it as it goes. You know, it's kind of just a continuation of last week's news of, you know, John Titor saying that Okarin's going to be our savior. And, you know, Okarin was kind of trying to come to terms with that. He's like, there's no way it's true. But then Makise was kind of like, hey, you know what? It might be, you know, like if this ability is real and you're the only one who can, you know, remember things when the world line changes, it must be true, right? So then they tried another experiment to make sure it was the case using Riku, Shining Finger, let's just call her Shining Finger, And then she ended up disappearing. So we don't know where she's at. Like, she's still alive. She was still texting him. She was saying, oh, like, I'm busy, I'll email you later. So she's still alive, but she basically just never showed up to, because of the email they sent back to her, she ended up never showing up to the lab. So that's where it's at with her. And then I think the last thing we saw was Ruka. So Ruka overheard them, and then she was like, hey, you know what? Like, I've always kind of, because Ruka's is a boy who looks very feminine. And Ruka was saying, hey, like, I've always wanted to be a girl. You know, I'm more comfortable that way. People have always talked about my appearance, and it made me uncomfortable, and I want to become a girl. And then Ruka was saying, hey, just send my mom, like, a text saying, eat more vegetables and you become a girl and you'll have a healthy baby. Thinking that vegetables, the more vegetables you eat during pregnancy, the more likely you are to have a baby girl. So Okarin sent that through, even though the there's no statistical evidence behind that. That's a whole lot of cap. But Okarin sent it through because, you know, he's a good youth. He's like, yo, Ruka needs this, because clearly the boy has been on his mind for a while, and he wants a sex change. And I feel like that's totally fine. Ruka would fit perfectly in 2021. You know what I'm saying? Fit perfectly in 2021. But yeah, we don't know if it worked though. I think it worked because Ruka, after the email was sent, Ruka kind of covered up like this, and Ruka was kind of sitting. I'm gonna call her she now, but like, she was kind of sitting more like feminine, you know what I'm saying? Like, she had like her arms in front of her, and you know, Makise was like, oh, don't look at Ruka, you pervert. So I think it worked, but Okarin thinks it didn't. So that's kind of where it's at right now. But basically, this week's episode was a bunch of tests of D-mail to kind of test Okarin's ability, you know, see if like it really is just him who's able to remember things as the world line changes. And it is in fact true, because we've now had three experiments where he's the only one who knows that things have changed. So yeah, that's where we're at with this episode, Steins Gate episode 8. I think it was good. I'll give it a 8.5 out of 10. If you guys enjoyed my review, please make sure to leave a like, comment down below your thoughts on the episode, and as always, if you're new to the channel, help me out and hit that subscribe button. And yep, it's been your boy Ghost Pagino, and I'm gonna see y'all next time.